Good morning, children. Let's proceed with the remaining word problems of the lesson Applications of Trigonometry, that is the concept of heights and distances. Question number 7. From a point on ground, the angles of elevation of the top and bottom of a transmission tower from a building fixed on the top of a 20 meter high building are 60 degree and 45 degree. Find the height of the tower. So after reading the question, you will understand the objects which are in the question, as there is a 20 meter tall building as well as a transmission tower fixed on the top of the building. From a point on ground, the angles of elevation, that means from the same point there are two places to which the angles of elevation is mentioned. How do you represent it? So let AB represents the building 20 meter tall, and let BC be the transmission tower. H, we have to find the height of the transmission tower. Let D be a point on ground. So if you are watching from the point D, BA, this is the line of horizontal. The first angle is formed to the base of the transmission tower. An angle is formed here, angle of elevation. And then again, from the point B to the point C, that is, an angle is formed with the horizontal. So the first angle is 45 degree and the bigger angle is 60 degree. You need to get the height of the transmission tower. How to introduce? Let AB is equal to 20 meter be the building, BC be the transmission tower, such that, mention about the angle, CDA, angle CDA is equal to 60 degree, and BDA, angle BDA is equal to 45 degree. You need to get the height of BC. Understood? Now, after drawing the picture and giving introduction, identify the two right triangles. Which are the right triangles? BAD is the first triangle. And which is the next triangle? Triangle CAD. After identifying the triangles, see the measures of the sides. In triangle BAD, the length AB is known to you and the angle ADB is 45 degree. So directly you can get the value of the adjacent side by the tan ratio, because angle ADB is 45 degree. For angle ADB, you have the opposite side and you need to get the adjacent side. Let's name this AD length as X. As we always used to tell you, the horizontal distance you can mark it as X. So from the first triangle, in triangle BAD, look here, triangle BAD, here, this is the angle. Tan 45 is equal to AB divided by AD. Tan 45 value is 1 is equal to AB length is 20 by AD length is X. By cross multiplication, X equal to 20, so you highlight it. That means you got the value of X as also 20. Mark it in the figure so that it will be easy for you to work out with the next triangle. Now pick out the next triangle as CAD. In that, you already got the length of the base. The total length CA is made up of AB plus BC. That is, it is 20 plus H. How do you apply the ratio? In triangle CAD, the angle is 60. Tan 60 is equal to the total length AC by the base length is AD. What is the value of tan 60? Root 3 is equal to AC is made up of 20 plus H by AD length is 20. The next step, cross multiply. 20 root 3 is equal to 20 plus h. You need to get the length of h. Subtract. That means 20 root 3 minus 20 is equal to h. Please be careful from here the calculation. Now see, the one method is 20 into 1.73 minus 20, or in this step you can take the common factor outside. That is, the next step is 20 into root 3 minus 1. That means h value is 20 into root 3 minus 1. Now, since the word is heights and distances, the value of root 3 is 1.73. Therefore, what will be the value of root 3 minus 1? 1.73 minus 1 is 0.73. What will be the value of root 3 plus 1? 1.73 plus 1 is 2.73. Why did I say this is, in most of your problems, the multiplication will be, the final answer multiplication will be either with root 3 or root 3 minus 1 or root 3 plus 1, because the angles which are in the textbook which is mentioned for you is only 30, 60 and 45. Definitely most of the answers will be any of these calculations. So even if you learn it as such, no problem. So what will be the final answer? H is equal to 20 into root 3 minus 1 is 0.73. 3 2s are 6, 7 2s are 14. So remove 2 decimal place. That means height of transmission tower is equal to 14.6 meter. So for the word problems, even if the value is not given for root 3, you just by heart it, because leave the answer with a specific number, because you can always multiply with root 3, root 3 minus 1 or root 3 plus 1. Question number 8, I will work out side by side because the picture will be the same, just opposite as the length of AB will be unknown and the length of BC is unknown. If you read the question, you will understand. So, we'll see the different, both the type of calculations in the same page. Question number 8. A statue 1.6 meter tall stands on the top of a pedestal. That means, let AB represents the pedestal and let BC 1.6 meter, that means this represents the statue. And now a similar explanation. From a point on ground, the angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degree. That means from a point on ground, the normalized side is DA. Angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degree. That means angle formed ADC is 60 degree. And the angle of elevation of, from the same point, angle of elevation of the top of the pedestal is 45 degree. Top of the pedestal. Top of the pedestal and the base of the statue is the same point. Top of the pedestal is 60 degree, means BD line will be joined. Angle formed here is 45 degree. The smallest angle is 45 and the bigger angle is 60 degree. A similar question. Find the height of the pedestal. Now, only the calculation part you have to be careful, because slight difference in the calculation part. Which are the triangles? Let give the introduction as, let AB is equal to h meter represents the pedestal. Then, BC equal to 1.6 meter be the statue, such that, mention about the angle, CDA is equal to 60 degree and BDA is equal to 45 degree. The two triangles are BAD. The right triangles are in triangle BAD, and which is the second triangle? CAD. We will pick out only the right triangles. Now, here, if you pick out the triangle BAD, the length of AB is also unknown, as well as the length of AD is also unknown. That was the difference from this question. From this question, the length of AB is known, so directly you were getting the value of AD. Here, both the measurements are unknown to you. How do you proceed? So, in triangle BAD, again, the value is 45. Tan 45 is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Tan 45 value is 1. 1 is equal to h by x, or by cross multiplication, x is equal to h. That means in all the questions, you will eliminate x. That means you will separate the value of x. You leave it as x is equal to h. Then, the next triangle, apply again. In triangle CAD, tan 16 is equal to h plus 1.6 by the length of x. What's the value of tan 16? Root 3 is equal to h plus 1.6 by x value and h value are equal. H cross multiply, root 3h is equal to h plus 1.6. Transpose h to the left side. Root 3h minus h is equal to 1.6. The same rule as you have done here. What is the meaning of root 3h minus h? You have to take the common factor h outside. That is, h into root 3 minus 1 is equal to 1.6. How do you calculate h? H is equal to 1.6 divided by root 3 minus 1. Now, how to simplify it? You cannot leave an answer like this. How to simplify is rationalize with root 3 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1. Root 3 plus 1 by, let me write it as next step. H is equal to 1.6 by root 3 minus 1 into root 3 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1. Again, h into, don't open, the bracket should not be open, 1.6 into root 3 plus 1 by, what is root 3 plus 1 into root 3 minus 1? Root 3 the whole square minus 1 the whole square. That is 1.6 into root 3 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 and 1.6 will get cancelled as 0.8. So what will be the final answer? You can multiply with 2.73. 0.8 into 2.73. That is 273 into 8. 2184, 1, 2, 3 decimal place, point into, so that means 2.184. How do you rewrite the answer? Therefore, the height of the pedestal is equal to 2.184 meter. So the calculations from here, you will never land up into division. Always we convert into multiplication by rationalizing the denominator. For rationalizing the denominator, we multiply and divide by the conjugate of the denominator. Question number 9. The angle of elevation of the top of a building from the foot of a tower is 30 degree, and the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from the foot of the building is 60 degree. See, by seeing the angle 60 degree, you can understand that the tower is at a greater height. Now, If the tower is 50 meter high, find the height of the building. So there are two objects here, a building and a tower. So let AB represents the building and CD represents the tower. CD represents the tower. What is the first sentence? The angle of elevation of the top of the building from the foot of the tower. Which is the foot of the tower? C. Which is the top of the building? P. So that means from C, the normal eyesight is CA. From here, the angle of elevation, that means this angle is found to be 30 degree, and the angle of elevation of the top of the tower at the foot of the building is 60 degree. That means the normal eyesight from A is in this direction, looking onto the top of the tower. So this is the building, this is the tower, and that angle formed here is 60 degree. Now, if the tower is 50 meter high, the height of the tower is 50 meter, find the height of the building. That is the question. So, how to introduce? Let AB be the building and CD is equal to 50 meter be the tower, such that, which is the angle formed here, CAD is equal to 60 degree. Second angle, ACB, and angle ACB is equal to 30 degree. After forming the picture, the first concept is to identify the two right triangles. Which are the two right triangles here? The first right triangle is ACD. The second right triangle is CAB. So, first triangle is in triangle ACD. The second triangle is in triangle CAB. Now, check the sides of both the triangles. Triangle ACD. The full length CD is given to you, and you know the angle is 60 degree. So, the base AC can be found out directly. Whereas if you take triangle BCA, both AB as well as AC is unknown to you. So start with the triangle in which the measure CD is known to you. In triangle ACD, tan 60 is equal to opposite side CD by adjacent side AC. Let's call it as X. Tan 60 is root 3 is equal to CD length is 50 by AC length is X, or root 3 into X is equal to 50, or X is equal to 50 divided by root 3. Highlight it, and we can use the value of X in the next triangle. The value of X is 50 by root 3. In triangle CAB, which is the angle here, angle ACB, that is again tan 30 is equal to AB, we call it as H. AB by AC, tan 30 value is 1 by root 3 is equal to, AB is unknown, you are going to find out as H by AC length is X. What's the value of X? H by X. 1 by root 3 is equal to H by, replace X by 50 by root 3. Directly you can cross multiply. What is 1 into 50 by root 3? 50 by root 3 is equal to, 1 into 50 by root 3 is equal to root 3 H. Again cross multiply as 50 is equal to root 3 into root 3 H, or 50 is equal to 3H, or what is the height? 50 divided by 3, because root 3 into root 3 is 3. It's a recurring number, 16.666 it will be recurring, or you can take it as 16.67. How do you present answer? Therefore, height of the building is equal to
16.67 meter.
This is an important 3-mark question. Question number 10. Another important question. Two poles of equal height are standing opposite each other on either side of a road which is 80 meter wide. Two poles of equal height. Underline that word, equal height. So let AB be the first pole and CD be the second pole of equal height. They are on either side of a road which is 80 meter wide. That means the total AC is given as 80 meter. And now, from a point between them on the road, so somewhere between them, you can take it little here, from a point between them on the road, the angles of elevation of the top of the poles are 60 degree and 30 degree. The angle of elevation, either BD and angle ADB can be 30 or ADB can be 60 also, there is no hard and fast rule. From D, angle of elevation to both the points, this angle, let E be the point on the road. Any one angle, one is 30 degree and the other one is 60 degree. You need to get what is the height of the pole and what are the distances or what is the point E, how far it is from A or how far it is from C. So here the first concept is 80. The total length is 80. Take one of the measures as X. What will be the other measure? It will be 80 minus X. Give an introduction as let AB equal to CD equal to H be the poles. Let E be the point on the road such that, mention about the angle as angle AEB is equal to 30 degree and angle CED is equal to 60 degree. The main concept is the total length of AC will be divided as X and 80 minus X. Identify the two right triangles. Which are the right triangles? The first one BAE. And which is the next right triangle? DCE. Triangle BCE. Which triangle we should take first? Here, when you see the measure, AB is unknown, AE is also unknown. Similarly, CD is unknown, CE is also unknown. So let's proceed with triangle BAE. Tan 30 is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, adjacent side AB by AE. Tan 30 value is 1 by root 3 is equal to AB is H by X. As I told you, X is equal to root 3 H. Highlight. Eliminate X. Next triangle. In triangle DCE, tan 60 is equal to CD by CE. Tan 60 value is root 3. Root 3 is equal to H by CE length is 80 minus X. Then by cross multiplication, root 3 is substituting the value of X first. H by 80 minus, what is the length, value of X? Root 3H. By cross multiplying, root 3 into 80 minus root 3H is equal to 1 into H or H. By distributive law, 80 root 3 minus root 3 into root 3 is 3H is equal to H. 80 root 3 is equal to H plus 3H. 4H is equal to 80 root 3 or H is equal to 80 root 3 by 4, which is equal to 20 root 3, which is equal to 20 into 1.732, that is
2 2s are 4, 3 2s are 6, 7 2s are 14, 3, 10. 1, 2, 3 please. So that is 34.64. Therefore, how do you rewrite? Height of the pole is equal to 34.64 meter. They wanted the distance x, which will be easy to substitute. X is equal to root 3 h. What is the value of h? It is 20 root 3. Substitute that value, it will be easy for you. Root 3 into 20 root 3. 20 root 3 into root 3 is 20 into 3, 60. Therefore, distance AE is equal to 60 meter and CE is equal to 80 minus 60, that is 20 meter. This is also an important 4-mark question. Number 11. A TV tower stands vertically on a bank of a canal. From a point on the other bank directly opposite to the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 60 degrees. From another point 20 meter away from this point, on the line joining this point to the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation is found to be 30 degrees. Find the height of the tower and the width of the canal. So a TV tower stands vertically on the bank of a canal. So let number 11. Let AB represents the TV tower. From a point on the other bank directly opposite to the tower. That means let AC. From the point C, that means CA represents the canal. From the point C, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 60 degrees. That means this value, this angle is found to be 60 degrees. From another point 20 meter away from this point, the angle of elevation is found to be 30 degrees. That means from this point, again retreating back or going away from that point, you are again looking on to the top of this tower. The angle is becoming 30 degrees. The more farther you are going, you can see that angle is getting reduced. So there is a concept in such questions, greater angle towards right angle. Towards right angle. Any of these figures, like when you move on, the angle is getting larger and larger. Now, this is 20 meter away from that. Find the height of the tower and width of the canal. That means the tower is also unknown to you, width of the canal is also unknown to you. How do you give the explanation? Let AB is equal to H meter, comma AC is equal to X meter represents the TV tower and the width of the canal, such that angle ACB is equal to 60 degrees and angle ADB is equal to 30 degrees. This introduction part you can write on your own. The angle should be mentioned. That's a very important point. Which are the two right triangles you can see here? First right triangle is BAC. Triangle BAC. Which is the second right triangle, BAD. You cannot take any other triangle, we'll take only the right triangles. Now, moving on with the triangle BAC, tan 60 is equal to, directly you can write it as H by X. Root 3 is equal to H by X. By cross multiplying, root 3X is equal to H. Eliminate x as h by root 3. Whatever be the value you are getting, you can eliminate x. That means the three cases which has in that position is either x and h are equal, or x is equal to root 3h, or x is equal to h by root 3. These are the only possible cases. Again, I am telling you, because the angles considered are 30 degree and 60 degree. That means x is equal to h can be a possibility when the angle is 45 degree. X is equal to h by root 3 when the angle concerned is 60 degree. And x is equal to root 3h when the angle is 30 degree. Applying this in the second triangle. In triangle BAD. This is triangle BAC. Tan 60 is equal to. Now, applying this in triangle BAD. Tan 30 is equal to h by. The length of AD is 20 plus x. What's the value of tan 30? 1 by root 3 is equal to h by 20 plus. Replace x with h by root 3. See the calculation? Cross multiplication. 20 plus h by root 3 is equal to root 3 h. Now, this step, you cannot simply transpose to the other side. Take LCM, then either way you have to take the LCM. So, LCM is root 3. This is by 1. So, into root 3 into root 3. That is 20 root 3 plus h by root 3 is equal to root 3h. 20 root 3 plus h is equal to root 3 into root 3h. 20 root 3 plus h is equal to 3h. 20 root 3 is equal to 2h, or h is equal to 20 root 3 by 2, which is equal to 10 root 3. Therefore, what is the height of the TV tower? Height of TV tower is equal to 10 into 1.732 or 17.32 meter. Answer in the back of the textbook is with irrational factor root 3, but since it's a fixed value, you can apply the value as 1.732. What is the width of the canal? Width of the canal is equal to x is equal to h by root 3. The value of h substitute as 10 root 3. So that easy calculation, 10 root 3 by root 3, which is equal to 10. Width of the canal is equal to 10 meter. And now here, this another calculation is 20 plus h by root 3 is equal to root 3h. You can transpose the value to the other side. 20 is equal to root 3h minus h by root 3. Still LCM is compulsory, by 1 into root 3. The same answer will come as 3h minus h. 20 root 3 is equal to 2h, or h is equal to 10 root 3. Both ways, any one of the way you can study, but LCM is compulsory. Question number 12. Very important question. From the top of a 7 meter high building, the angle of elevation of the top of a cable tower is 60 degree and the angle of depression of its foot is 45 degree. Determine the height of the tower. From the top of a 7 meter high building. That means there are two objects here, building and tower. From the top of a 7 meter high building. Let AB represents the 7 meter high building. From the top of this building, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is found to be 60 degree. That means the normal eyesight here, this angle is 60 degree. And from the same point, angle of depression, that means from here to here, it is 45 degree. So, how to find the height of the tower? That means you need to find the total height CD. Given introduction as, let AB equal to 7 meter be the building, CD is the tower, CD represents the tower, such that angle DBE is equal to 60 degree and angle EBC is equal to 45 degree. Since these two lines are parallel, this angle also will be 45 degree by alternate interior angle. We can mention that angle EBC is equal to angle ACB is equal to 45 degree as alternate interior angles. Also, AB is equal to CE is equal to 7 meter. AB is equal to CE is equal to 7 meter. Now, which are the two triangles under consideration? You can consider the triangle here as BAC. You can also consider BEC. EC is angle BAC, triangle BAC. In triangle BAC, and which is the next right triangle, triangle BET, triangle BET. Apply the ratios. Now, from this triangle, you will get the base length AC. That same AC will correspond to BE also. So, the first triangle BAC, tan 45 is equal to, opposite side is AB, adjacent side is AC, let's mark it as X. 1 is equal to 7 by X, or X is equal to 7. That same 7 meter BE also will take, we have already written. Therefore, BE is also 7 meter. Apply in the triangle BED. In triangle BED, tan 60 is equal to, let's take this unknown length as small h. H by 7, this length is, let me write BE by BE. Root 3 is equal to h by 7, or what is the value of h? H is equal to 7 root 3. That h is not the total height of the tower. So, what's the total height of the tower? Therefore, height of the tower is equal to, total height is CD, which is made up of CE and DE. What's the length of CE? 7. What's the length of DE is 7 root 3. How to get the answer? Common as 1 plus root 3, or 7 into 2.73. 2.73 into 7, 21.2, that is 19.11, height of the tower is 19.11 meter. The remaining questions and worked out examples we will do in the next class.